welcome to this lesson where we're going to start learning Get Ready. This is another classic. It's a very simple song to pick up with the band because all you got is that main riff and the four chorus chords. But as always, we're going to dive deep into this and see what we can learn from the song rather than just learning a version that we can get away with, so to speak. So today we'll look at the main riff and all the different variations that I could come up with. There are obviously more than in these examples. I'm doing one example for each area, right? And I'm actually doing two variations in each, but there are even more. And my conclusion was that these work best for me. But if you have this mindset of you look at how to play something in every area of the neck and you try it out, you'll discover that you'll find things there that you wouldn't have just come up with. They come out because you try them. You force yourself through every area. So I'll give you a quick example here. For this area here, the G minor shape, so we're in, it's D minor is the riff is in. Yeah, so we got, if I'm gonna play the riff here. Yeah. Okay, so really simple. Okay, so you could put chords on these last two notes. Instead of playing the notes G and F, you could play the chords G and F. Probably without thirds. If there were thirds in there, that'd be major. But I think for this song, whenever you play during the verse or the riff section of the song, it happens in the chorus tag, whenever that comes back, if you're going to put the chords in, put five chords in. So that's a chord without a third. So an F, for example, F5 will be here. Because I'm using the fifth and the root from that chord. That's the third, right? So I don't play that. So in this area of the neck then, let's see, that's one F, and another F will be here, from the A shape, right? Exactly the same notes. But it's about finding it working in an area. So let's see what those could, how those, we could incorporate both those. So if we're coming from here, that's our G chord, and then F there, right? So we could move down there, and that would be in a new shape for the D minor, but still, that works. Right? If we want to stay in this area, and that's quite a nice one to do that too. So there you go, that's two versions. Or you could maybe play only one note on the first chord. Vary it like that, yeah? And then, as I was doing that, as I was going through that and, you know, writing it down and stuff, thinking, oh, shall I go there? Or, well, if I go from there to there, I could play the riff here next time and can move myself around the neck in that way. Anyway, excuse me. As I was doing that, I thought, oh, I could do one of those, like, bends that Hendrix used to do. So this one. You heard that, right, before? So I thought I could do that here. And now that this area, which started off being a little bit awkward, right? Oh, I'm out of there and I don't know, it's a bit stretchy. But now... Yeah? That's, I love that. You can, like, really bend that note there, but you keep that one still. So that was... Because I forced myself to work out the riff in every area. You know, I had it down here, for example. But there's a little ornament that you can sometimes put in. Here. Yeah. And I can't do that here. Because I don't have any strings below, right? So, but you try it everywhere. And you'll come up with things like that. So now I got this riff sounding like this. which I think is quite cool, you know? Anyway, I'm saying this because when you try these five examples, have a look and see if you could come up with something that you like. One shape that I was like banking on, this is going to be really good, like the open D shape. But that sounded quite thin. I don't like that G string there. And then I thought, well, it could be a chord as well, the G chord. And that's a five chord there. But then the F here, that sounds wrong. There's a third there in the F. I think these chords work better as five chords, so I could go up here, I suppose. But now it feels disjointed. So what about... And then from that F there... Right? And I thought that was going to be really good. But then when I'm playing it along to the track, it didn't feel that great, you know? So things that you think might work out may turn out that they don't. And things that you don't think are going to work out may turn out that they do. So anyway, these are the five examples that I thought were all right for this. You may disagree if you do come up with or tweak them somehow to make it sound right for you, right? Okay, anyway, here are the examples.